Hello to everyone in St Paul's. Father Ken, your chaplain, speaking. Just a little message as we look forward to the celebration of the birth of Jesus. Once upon a time is a phrase you'll have heard used quite a lot. It's a powerful combination of words that have a great ability to attract and command our attention. Everyone who hears these words sits up and listens. A story's coming, and everybody loves a story. Our Christmas celebrations proclaim a once upon a time story. It's an old story, 2,000 years old, charming, full of mystery, and told by a man called Luke, who tradition says was a doctor. It begins like this. Once upon a time, the mighty God of heaven decided to give a gift to the people of planet Earth, that gift, himself. There are all kinds of images, characters, and props in the story. Emperors and wise men, angels and shepherds, heavenly choirs, a young pregnant teenage girl away from home and her caring young partner. There's darkness, there's silence, there's shining stars, there's a stable and a newborn baby with eyes open to gather in the views of a new world. It's a very familiar story. We know it well, and each year at this time we're asked to listen to it again. Why? Because although the tale is old, it's a never new story of good news for all, tidings to be shared by all people. A pitch dark night in a small town of Bethlehem. The census tapers are bending over their ledgers, filling in all the details. Soldiers were patrolling the streets when in a deserted stable, a young girl called Mary gave birth to a son, a child born of people without any importance, people from the country, victims of the rulers of church and state. And then the angels came. They did not go to the censors or to Herod the king. They went to the most marginalised people in the area, shepherds, the lowest of the low. So, as we look forward to Christmas, what does this tell us? It tells us that the great and the good, though they were ordering world affairs unnoticed except for a chosen few, God was changing the history of the world. And this message, this story teaches in these difficult pandemic times a message not of despair, but of hope. It tells its homeless, its big issue sellers, its hungry and us of a God who cares enough to send his son into the world where he will become one of the poor. So as you begin your Christmas holidays and look forward to time with your family, the message is a very simple one in this difficult year. It's take care, look after yourself, look after others. So in his name, Emmanuel, I wish you great joy and peace and blessings this time and for the year ahead. And thank you for listening and have a wonderful Christmas.
Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you're looking forward to Christmas. I know I am. This has been a very different year for us all, one that we have achieved so much through working together and supporting each other. And for that, I would like to say a massive thank you to you all for following the guidelines and restrictions we've put in place to keep everyone safe. You have done really well wearing your masks, sanitising your hands, wiping desks and sticking to the one-way system. So for that, a very big thank you. There's lots we haven't been able to do this year, such as gathering in big groups, celebrations, school trips, parents' evenings, our Advent services and school masses, all to keep each other safe. Hopefully it won't be too long before we can return to school as we know it, and we can follow, you know, we can mix the seniors and juniors together, so you can start to form new friendships and the seniors can support the juniors. And that's something that's been difficult for the seniors because normally they would have that role in the school. I'm sure they're looking forward to spending time with the younger ones, particularly the new first years that they haven't really had a chance to meet yet. To the seniors, you have worked so hard to ensure that you achieve the best qualifications you can, and we will continue to support you with this after the holidays. There's quite a lot of hard work ahead, you know that, but we're here to support you. The younger pupils, you have learned lots of new subjects, new skills and knowledge that will help you with your future and for you to become the best you can be. We've all learned new skills online this year. We've got used to things like Google Classroom, Microsoft Teams, Zoom calls, and many, many more. I think we all deserve to have a lovely time at Christmas and a good break from all of the hard work we've been doing in school. However, I would ask that you continue to follow the guidelines during the holidays and keep your family and friends safe. Although we give gifts at Christmas time, the best gift we can give is your time and your support and kindness to other people. So, a little message for you. Be nice, be kind, and be helpful at home. Tidy your room, do the dishes, simple things that will make a big difference for people at home. And that will help everyone to have a good Christmas too. So take care of yourself, keep safe, and we'll see you after the holidays. So have a Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year.
Nights are getting shorter now, hot chocolate fills the air and Christmas cheer does too. Picking on your Christmas tree so lovely, the joy this time it brings to you. Ooh, da-da-do, da-da-do.
Coming for us. Santa's coming for us. Santa's coming for us.